Welcome to Nagesh Karasgi Orchid School. I am Savita teacher and I am teaching grade 4 science class. Dear students, in grade 3 in science lesson you have learnt that different animals eat different foods and they have mouth parts suitable to the type of food they eat. And you know that herbivores, that is plant eaters, have sharp broad front teeth and flat back teeth. You also know that carnivores, means meat eater, have long sharp front teeth and broad flat back teeth. Dear student, you know that some animals like snake, frog can swallow their food. What about humans? Humans have to chew their food before swallowing it. And dear student, being an omnivore, a human have different kinds of teeth. In previous lesson, you have learnt that chewing food properly before swallowing it is very important as it makes digestion of food much easier. And teeth are used for biting and chewing the food. So, in today's lesson number 3, teeth and microbes, we are going to learn about the different kinds of teeth, the structure of a tooth, and how should you take care of your teeth. Now, do you know when you got your first tooth? Ask your parents. Usually, a child gets his or her first tooth at the age of 6 or 7 months. You can see that when a child is of 6 or 7 months old, he get his first tooth. A three years old child usually has 20 teeth. And this first set of teeth is called milk teeth or temporary teeth. When the child is about 6 years old, the milk teeth begin to fall out. And new teeth that are bigger start growing in their place. You can see after that 6 years, the big teeth, means milk teeth, fall out and bigger teeth are starting growing in their place, and these are called permanent teeth. By the time the child becomes an adult, then he or she has 32 permanent teeth. Now we will see the kinds of teeth. When you open your mouth and look at your upper and lower jaw in the mirror, you can see different kinds of teeth. Now we will see if we compare the teeth in the front with, when you compare the teeth in the front with the back teeth, something different you can see. What difference do you find? You will see that different type of teeth in your mouth. You can see here in front, these are different type. Here also they have different shape in upper jaw and in lower jaw. You can see the different types of teeth. The teeth are of different shapes because they have different uses. An adult has four kinds of teeth. They are incisors, canines, premolars and molars. Now we will see incisors. They are the four front teeth in each jaw. You can see here the four front, these four front teeth in each jaw. In upper jaw also these four front teeth, and in lower jaw these four front teeth. These are called incisors. They help to cut and bite the food. These front teeth help you to cut and bite food. That's why they are called cutting teeth. If you see here, four front teeth are incisors in upper jaw, and in lower jaw also four front teeth are incisors. So there are 8 incisors in all. Now we will see next type of teeth, that is canines. The canines are next to the incisors. They are sharp and pointed. They are used for tearing food like meat. That's why they are called tearing teeth. There are 4 canines in all. You can see here 2 canines in upper jaw and 2 canines in lower jaw. So there are 4 canines in all, and these canines are used for tearing food. That's why they are called tearing teeth. Now we will see next type of teeth, that is premolars. The premolars are the 2 teeth next to each canine. They are flat and wide. You can see here which is pointed. Next to canine, each canine 2 teeth are there. These are called premolars. This side also. See, these are premolars and they are flat and wide. They help to crush food. That's why they are called crushing teeth. There are 8 premolars in all. You can see here 4 premolars in upper jaw and 4 premolars in lower jaw. So there are 8 premolars in all, and these premolars help you to crush food. That's why they are called crushing teeth. Now we will see molars. The molars are the 3 teeth at back of the mouth, that is next to premolars. You can see here it is pointed. These back 3 teeth are premolars and they are next to premolars. Sorry, these 3 teeth are molars and those are next to these premolars. They are broader and they help to grind the food. That's why they are called grinding teeth. There are 12 molars in all. You can see 6 molars in upper jaw and 6 molars in lower jaw. There are 12 molars in all. Now we will see an adult has 4 incisors, 2 canines, 4 premolars and 6 molars in upper jaw. You can see here these 4 incisors, 2 canines and 4 premolars and these 6 molars in upper jaw, and same way in lower jaw also 4 incisors, 2 canines, 4 premolars and these 6 molars. So in total there are 32 teeth in all. Now we will see structure of a tooth. part of the tooth that can be seen above the gum is called the crown. You can see here, the part which can be seen above the gum is called crown. The outer layer of the crown is made of a substance called enamel. You can see it is pointing there. This outer layer of the crown is made of a substance called enamel. The enamel is the hardest substance in your body, and it is very difficult to scratch the surface of this layer. Means it is very hard, it is very difficult to scratch the enamel. Now, beneath the enamel is a layer of dentine. You can see here, it is not hard as hard as enamel. You can see beneath the enamel, this outer layer, just now we seen, this outer layer is called enamel. It is very hard, and beneath the enamel is a layer of dentine, and it is not as hard as enamel. The innermost portion of the tooth is called the pulp, and the pulp contains blood vessels and nerves. You can see here, the innermost part of the tooth is called pulp, and this pulp contains blood vessels and nerves. Now, the part of the tooth that is inside the gum is called the root. It holds the tooth firmly in the place. If you can see here, this is gum part. Here it is named gum, and this part is bone. So, inside the gum, this part of tooth is called root, and root holds the tooth firmly in the place. Same as the root of the plant holds plant firmly in the soil. Now, dear students, have you ever had a toothache? Few of you may experience toothache. Did the aching tooth have a black hole in it? Now, we will see what things damage to your teeth. When you eat, small bits of food remains or get stuck between your teeth. And you will see that if these bits of food are not removed, small living organism or small living things called germs start growing on them. If you don't remove the food, bits of food, those are stuck in your teeth. If you don't remove that, small living things called germs start growing on them, and these germs produce substance called acids which harm your teeth, means the part of enamel. If you don't remove the bits of food from your teeth, that produce germs, and germs produce substance called acids which harm the enamel. Then you can see small hole called cavity starts growing on your teeth, means small hole called cavity then form on the tooth. That acid starts attacking on your enamel, and that create a hole on the tooth. And as germs continue to attack the enamel, the cavity become bigger and deeper. You can see, if you are not taking care of your mouth or not brushing properly, so that germs continue to attack the tooth, and the cavity become bigger and deeper. and if a cavity reaches the pulp, the tooth starts hurting. You can see, as the enamel is very hardest part and dentine is not hard, not as hard as enamel, and pulp is the innermost part of the tooth. When the cavity will start from enamel part, when if the germs keep on continuing the attack, afterwards the cavity become bigger and deeper, and when it reaches the pulp, the tooth starts hurting. And if you look after your teeth, that is permanent teeth, properly, they will last a lifetime. You have to take care of your permanent teeth properly, then they will last a lifetime. But if you do not look after your permanent teeth, then they may decay or rot and fall out. And once a permanent tooth fall out, new tooth will not grow in their place. Once if this permanent tooth will fall out, then new tooth will not grow in that place. So it is very important that you have to take care of your permanent teeth. It is very important that you have to look after your permanent teeth. Now we will see how you should take care of your teeth. You should wash your mouth after every meal. It removes the food, bits of food that stuck between your teeth. You should brush your teeth twice a day. This removes bits of food stuck between your teeth. And you should follow proper brushing technique. So when you will brush your teeth, you should brush at least for 2 minutes, and you should move your brush up and down when you are brushing your front teeth, and when you are brushing your back teeth, you should move your brush in a circle. So this is a proper technique of brushing. That what is that? You have to brush for at least 2 minutes, and when you are brushing your front teeth, you should move your brush up and down, and when you are brushing your back teeth, you should move it in a circle. You should follow these techniques to brush your teeth properly. And you have to visit a dentist. Ask your parents to take you to a dentist periodically to check for cavities. If there are cavities, then the dentist can help you avoid further damages to your teeth. If you have any cavities, so dentist can help you to avoid the further damage of your teeth. That's why it is very important that you should visit dentist periodically. Now you should take a good diet that is good for your teeth. So what you have to do, you have to drink plenty of water, and you should drink milk regularly and eat green leafy vegetables. You know that this milk give you calcium, and leafy vegetables give you vitamin A, and calcium and vitamin A both are good for teeth. If you want strong teeth, you should follow the good eating habits, and you should include a proper diet in your teeth. You should include proper diet that will help to keep your teeth good. Now for good teeth, what you should avoid, we will see. You should avoid eating sticky chocolates and sweets. And you must avoid fizzy drinks because they have acids in them and they are not good for your teeth. If you eat sticky chocolates and sweet, it will get stick in on your teeth and your teeth starts rotting. And you must avoid fizzy drinks because they have acids in them and they are not good for your teeth. Now we will do one activity. In this activity is to study the effect of fizzy drinks on your teeth. And for this activity we will require a boiled egg with the shell intact and a glass and vinegar. In this method, what we are going to do, we have to place the boiled egg in a glass and pour the vinegar into the glass. Allow the glass to stand for a day and we have to observe what happens. Now, dear student, I am going to do this activity for you. Dear student, now I will do this activity for you. For this, I have taken a boiled egg and one glass and vinegar. So first I will do what I am doing, you just observe carefully. This is an boiled egg. I will place this in glass and I will pour vinegar on it. And we should allow this egg or this glass to stand for a day and then we have to observe what happened to the egg. Actually, now as it requires one day, what I did yesterday, one boiled egg I have put in a glass, same activity I followed yesterday. So that egg I will show you what happened with that egg. I will take this egg in the bowl so I can show you properly. Dear student, take note that what this activity we done now. Actually, what we did, we have taken one boiled egg and I placed that egg in the glass and I poured vinegar on it. And this glass should, we have to allow this glass to stand for one day. Then we have to observe that. But now already yesterday I have done this activity at home and I brought that egg to show you. Now I will show you. See, this enamel, some part of the some part of this shell is eaten by vinegar. And you can see how it is became soft. So the vinegar, whatever the acid present in the vinegar, that will eat the shell. Okay. Now this is what happened when, see, in the observation also, after one day you will notice that the shell is eaten away by the vinegar. This is what happens to the enamel of your teeth if you drink lots of fizzy drinks. Already I told you, in fizzy drinks acids are present. In vinegar also acetic acid is there. So we have done one activity to find out what the action of acids on the shell of egg. Actually, shell of egg is contains calcium. And the enamel of our tooth is also contains calcium. So what happened, the acids present in the fizzy drinks act on our enamel and it damage your enamel. So you should avoid fizzy drinks because they have acids in them and these acids are not good for your teeth. So in this way, in today's lesson, you have learnt that the different kinds of teeth, the structure of a tooth and how should you take care of your teeth. Now in short, I will recall these all points. You know that you have different kinds of teeth. you have four kinds of teeth. Those are incisors, canines, premolars and molars. And you know that there are four incisors in upper jaw and four incisors in lower jaw, and two canines in upper jaw and two canines in lower jaw. I will show you some slides again. We have seen that kinds of in teeth, there are four incisors in upper jaw and four incisors in lower jaw, and two canines in upper jaw and two canines in lower jaw, and then four premolars in upper jaw and four premolars in lower jaw, and six molars in upper jaw and six molars in lower jaw. And you know the function uses of these teeth also. So just recall and tell me what these incisors help us. These incisors help us to cut and bite the food. So these are also called as, yes, these are also called as, yes, we have seen the incisors are called cutting teeth because they help us to cut the food. Then we have seen the canine are called tearing teeth because they help us to tear the food. Then we have seen premolars are two teeth next to canine, and these premolars help to crush the food, that's why they are called crushing teeth. And you know that there are four premolars in upper jaw and four premolars in lower jaw. And after that we have seen that molars are also called as grinding teeth because they help to grind food, and there are 12 molars in all, means 6 molars in upper jaw and 6 molars in lower jaw. And in the structure of food, you have seen that we have learned that this part, the part of the tooth that can be seen above the gum, is called crown. And crown, the outermost layer of the crown, is made up of enamel, and enamel is very, it is the hardest part of your, enamel is the hardest substance in your body. The innermost part is called pulp, and pulp contains blood vessels and nerves. And you have seen how tooth get damaged. If food, bits of food stuck in your teeth, germs starts growing on that, and germs produce acids, and acid attacks on your teeth. And you can see that black hole form on the enamel, and as the germs continue to attack the tooth, the cavity become bigger and deeper, and when it reaches to the pulp, it starts hurting. And you know that once the permanent teeth fall out, no new teeth will grow in that place. So to see the action of acids, means how acids attack on the tooth, we have done this activity. So no need to do this activity, I have done for you here. And you know that how to take care of your teeth. So what you have to do, you have to brush your teeth twice a day, you have to follow proper brushing techniques, and you should avoid eating sticky chocolates and sweets, and you should avoid fizzy drinks because they have acids in them and they are not good for your teeth. And what you have to, you should have a good diet for good teeth, means you have to drink plenty of water, you should drink milk regularly, and you have to eat green leafy vegetables. I hope you will follow these all things whatever we learn today, good habits for good teeth. And dear student, you have to read the full lesson from your textbook. Today we learn lesson number 3, teeth and microbes. You have to read the lesson and you have to underline the new words and you have to learn that. Thank you.